So it's got a limited time of 15 minutes. Okay, so it's all right. We're running up and running again. So if you want to switch the water heater on gas, turn the outer ring to on. So that's off.
Right.
You can see that little thing there goes to the little flame. You see a little green light come on?
And temperature. Oh, yes.
You see that? Yeah. Yes. If the green light comes on, that means that's okay, it's lit.
Yep.
If it comes on red, that means it's failed to light.
Good.
Okay.
Yep.
So things to check are, one, you've obviously got gas, or you've turned your gas on, or that cover. You know that cover I showed you on the outside? Oh, if that's still on, it will just cut it out. Okay?
Check
all of that.
Yeah.
If it does go to red, switch it off. Do all them checks. Yep. Fire up your cooker, make sure you've got gas running, and then attempt to light it again. It may take 2 or 3 attempts if you haven't done it for a while. So
yeah.
What the likely thing is, it will have air in the system, and what you're doing every time you switch it on, off, on, off, is obviously purging the gas through. Or purging the air out to allow the gas to flow.
Right.
Okay?
Yep.
The difference between heating on gas and electric, on the gas side you have got more control. Okay?
Yep.
And electric is just thermostatically controlled to 70. With the gas you can vary it. Okay?
Yes. Yep.
You can operate on both if you wanted to.
Yes.
If you want to get the water heat quicker, rather rapid, obviously you can do that.
Which we
both at the same time if you want to.
That's
electric's quite...
That's when you're really confident that everything's shut off when it's temperatures get up.
That's it, yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so heater. So obviously you've got your fire here.
No.
You've obviously got a gas element and electric element behind there. Electric element is controlled by this one here. So you've got your little switch on your consumer board next to your water heater. Right, this one, it looks very similar to that one. It isn't gas. You see there it says 230 volts, so that is electric, ultra heat in your room. You've got the options of 500, 1000 or 2000 watts, so whichever one you want to set it to. Also you've got a thermostat control in the centre. Okay?
Yep.
So that's now heating an element up inside your fire. You've also got the gas option, okay, which is this control here, so don't fire up electric and gas at the same time. So to fire up your gas side of it, all you do is turn that round, hold it down, you can't hear it with the compressor going. It will automatically light. So you can see the flame down there through the window.
Yeah.
If you can see that or not. You see that?
Oh, yes, spot it. Yep.
So obviously, you know it's been, know it's lit.
Okay.
Okay, obviously to switch it off, bring it back to zero.
Can you feel the, oh yes.
Yeah, you
same
can.
As.
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's actually, you're not actually pressing it down to click it. All you're doing is pressing it down and holding it because there's an auto igniter on it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
This side of it is your fan.
Oh,
centre's off. To the right is auto, so what that is, auto fan is thermostatically controlled and increases it as it warms up. Okay, this side of it is your manual fan, which is this control obviously controls that. So as you want round to 5, so you can hear it. Obviously always make sure you've got some kind of fan running so it doesn't allow the element or whatever to overheat.
Okay.
Also you can use the fan on its own without heat, so if you want to blow air around the van, especially in the summer, you can do that as well. Okay. Obviously, when you obviously got heat on, it's always best to have the fan on anyway because you're blowing the air, circulating air around the vents anyway. Obviously, in your bathroom and in your room here. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Happy with your heating and your.
That's TV thing down.
Yeah, that's your TV point. Yeah.
And
a 12 volt point as well.
What is that?
That's a detector for movement for your alarm, which is on your fob here. So you just press a button. One beep, that's on. Set it off. Two's off. Yeah, it has also got a tilt sensor as well. So obviously if someone's winding it up to get onto their vehicle, then obviously that movement will set it off. So they are quite sensitive.
Yeah.
Okay, the rest of your keys, obviously big keys are doors, so you've got one on a spare. Little keys for your lockers, so again one on a spare. Okay. Right, your fridge. You can see that there. Little tiny button there, switches it on and off. Okay, so you just press and hold that and it switches it on and off. Blue light on it says it's working. You can see that?
Yeah.
Glows quite nicely in the dark. If I press any button, that'll light up the LCD because obviously it was just asleep. It's run on gas at the moment. Okay, to change the energy, press the left hand button. That's now running on electric. Okay, you hear that the gas went off. Also, you can run it on 12 volt system, but that's actually off your car. Okay, it won't cool the fridge down, it'll just maintain the temperature.
Yeah.
Okay, it's actually showed a failure now. At the moment, the blue light's flashing. You've got a little spanner in the screen as well. There.
Yeah.
The failure is because it's not detected an engine's running, obviously the car's connected.
Right. Yeah.
If it fails like that on your gas, that means the gas hasn't lit. Okay, so you go for the same procedure what you would with your boiler, so check you've got gas running. Fire up your cooker, just make sure got enough sufficient gas. If it does obviously fail on the gas, what you're going to have to do is switch it off. So you press and hold that, switch it totally off. Okay?
Yeah.
Give it a few seconds, then switch it back on again for it to reset. So. Again, it's trying to purge the air out of the system.
Okay.
Okay, take two or three attempts. But if you've got a solid blue light like that, it's lit. If you can hear it as well. You can just hear it burning.
Gently.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
This side of it is your temperature range, so you got all them five lit, that's the coldest it's going to be. So if you've got frozen butter coming out, obviously you don't need it that cold.
Down a bit.
Yeah, so two or three is probably about right. Okay, yeah. Obviously it all depends on the weather outside. If it's really hot, obviously it's going to need to work harder. And gas is more efficient for cooling the fridge than your electric. So if you're in a really hot climate, it might be better to work it on gas. Especially if you've got medication or whatever, electric may not get it down to the temperature it needs to be at or maintain.
Very interesting.
Okay.
Yep. Good to know.
I'll just put that onto electric. Okay. Obviously, to open the fridge is that one there. Inside the handle, got this little tab there that goes into there. So when it's in storage, it just allows the air to circulate. Yeah. Okay. So obviously,
that's a good idea.
Tries to prevent it from getting mouldy. Okay. It's also got a memory. So if I switch that off. So you press and all the switches it off, it will remember it was running on electric or gas or whatever. So obviously as long as that is connected, it will re-attempt to light back onto or electric operate on. Back on that.
Alright.
So you see that, look, it's operating on electric again. Okay.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'll switch that off there.
Yeah, I was going to say we've got a thing about having lights on in the night.
Right.
Glowing all over the place.
That really glows quite, I've got one exactly the same as that. Some people put a bit of insulation tape or something over the top of it if it is annoying.
Yeah.
Mm. Some of the more up-to-date ones now, everything goes off, so you can't see anything glowing in the dark. It's just got a little, on the on-off switch, it's got a tiny little pinprick hole. Mm. You can just see a little green light in, which doesn't light the whole van up.
That's it.
Okay.
Right,
cooker, 12-volt igniter there. You just turn, press and hold, and then fires it up. Okay. Obviously, don't close the glass when it's hot, so the risk of obviously shattering it. Mm. Your grill, exactly the same. Fire it up on, and you see that in the reflection.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm. Obviously, your grill pan's inside there. Obviously, you always operate it with the grill door open.
Oh, the one downstairs. Good.
Yeah.
So you're trying to bend your bust your back trying to get in there.
Yeah. It's quite low down. Inside here, you've got the individual gas appliance taps. You can see that on the left-hand wall. Okay, they are colour-coded, so we've got the info note on your door here, and which angle the switch has to be when it's on and off. Okay?
Good.
Yeah. You don't need to turn them on or off. Obviously, your main one is to turn it on top of your cylinder off. Okay? The reason for that is, obviously, when they're checking it, obviously doing gas checks, they turn them off. They may forget to turn them back on again. So if you're trying to operate
light
your cooker and it's not lighting, just check in there just to make sure that they've switched that back on.
Is
that electric?
Yeah, we've got an electric one as well, which is that control there.
That one, okay.
Yeah, which takes a while. Obviously you can't see that.
Electric.
Yeah, that's it. If you,
yeah.
I've only used it a few times with my van because I've always used the gas, but I'm starting to use that now. Especially for all the kids want to cook breakfast.
Oh,
you have to use it.
That.
Microwave, big one, opens it. Obviously, don't travel with glass plate in. If that drops out and drops onto here, it's going to be expensive. Okay, and it's quite a good one. I like these because it's straightforward and just on off, ping. That's it. That's all you need to know.
Right.
Okay, bathroom. Have you got your light switch here? Have you got a decent sized walking shower as well?
It's what swung us to this one. Yeah.
A bit of air in the system, doesn't it? Yeah. I might be drawing a bit of air because I've said about that pipe. When I pull it out, obviously I'll put a bit of air into it, haven't I? Inside here, you've got your directional aerial. Okay, you can see that there. Okay, with that one, what you can do, loosen the locking nut there. I've got a red spot there. Your little info note here says red spot denotes front of antenna. So that one on there, so that's the front of it. What you do is have a look, see where everybody else is pointing theirs. All you do is you can lift it up and turn it around to wherever you need it, lock it off. You can change the angle of the top of it as well, like this control here. Just spin it round and it'll go from horizontal to vertical. Obviously make sure it's in the horizontal one before you bring it back down, because Otherwise, you could end up with a dint in the top of your roof.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
Obviously, it's difficult to see from this angle as well. But also, inside here, which I forgot, is your amplifier hiding it behind there.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, which is quite tricky to get to. Just switching it on, want to switch it on and off. Okay?
All right.
Just try, I think now. I think that's everything. Just see, it's got radio. So you see this here, look, you've got your fan, you've got a directional, you can either direct it in or out. Obviously you've got speed. Speed is that one. Do not change direction if you think, oh, I want to draw it in and out rapid after one another. So don't put it on free and try and do that. Because
okay.
The likelihood it'll blow the fuse. Okay.
That's nice.
I've got to open the vent, obviously use that. Just be very careful before you travel, obviously you make sure that's down because it's very difficult to see inside.
Right.
But it's actually open enough.
So many times caravans going and saluting.
Well, I've seen one or two flying off the top of them. Yeah. You just got to be that careful.
Good.
Okay. Inside your front drawer. Obviously, you've got your handbook. Yeah. Then you've got the other bits of paperwork as well in there. Okay, so that's all sitting in there nicely. Okay.
Yep.
Right. What I need you to do now is go through the handover sheet.
Don't need this now.
No.